I want to first thank my Heavenly Father for putting me in this position. Thank you, Jesus. Ladies and gentlemen, a new dawn is starting. My family and I are so humbled to be gifted this opportunity to serve our state as Oklahoma's turnaround starts right here, right now. Folks, we have a great state, one that fills me and Sarah with tremendous pride. Oklahoma has all the resources we need to be a top 10 state. And I am ready to lead us there with your help. But our state has been through a difficult few years. These hardships did not evolve overnight. They were decades in the making. But it's time to end this cycle. It's time to take hold of our nation's improving economy and push the doors wide open for all 4 million Oklahomans to access prosperity, growth, and a brighter future. It's time, folks, to fix a broken government and to bring our agencies into the 21st century with structural reform and technology that delivers accountability and transparency to all hardworking taxpayers. And it's time for smart government, one that is customer-oriented and focused on delivering core services, services like education, and not a government that panders to big business and special interests. And let me take a minute just to address a big issue, central issue in this election cycle. We can have a top 10 education system. I believe it. And in the Stitt administration, we will value the teaching profession and work towards innovative solutions that are student-centered and ensure stability in core funding in the needs in our every single classroom. And it's time to make Oklahoma a place where every other state points to and says, this is what's possible. But to move Oklahoma forward, folks, to truly change the trajectory of our state, it's going to require all of us coming together to work together, Democrats, Republicans, rural and urban, to be united around a common vision. And that vision is to always make the hard decision that's right for the next generation and not the next election. So today, I had the honor to join my oldest daughter, Natalie, to vote. She voted for the very first time. She just turned 18. I'm so proud of her. Soon she'll be out on her own, making her own decisions. And I want her and I want Oklahoma to have a future that she can make her home here with a great future. And it's her generation, and it's the generation not yet born, that we will put first in a Stitt administration. So ladies and gentlemen, it's time for Oklahoma to take its rightful place as a top 10 state. Ladies and gentlemen, say it with me. Oklahoma's turnaround starts right here, right now. I want to thank my wonderful family, my wife Sarah. She is going to be the best first lady Oklahoma's ever had. And my six beautiful children, Natalie, Drew, Kate, Piper, Remington, and Houston, thank you guys so much. Appreciate you. This is an honor of a lifetime. And then my mom and dad to be on stage with me, John and Joyce, thank you. My two brothers, Keith and Kent. And all of my campaign staff, we had the best team in anywhere. I love them. Thank you, guys. And to all of my supporters that have been with me from the very beginning, I just cannot thank you enough for joining this movement. I'm so excited to be your governor and point us in the right direction for our future. To all the Oklahomans out there, it is time for Oklahoma to be a top 10 state. We have such a bright future. Cannot wait to lead us there.
So you're looking at the results. Almost all the precincts are reporting now.
And I want to thank my Gateway team members for all that they've done to put me to this spot. And we're going to celebrate this tonight, guys. Can't wait to hang out with you. And then we're going to get back to work tomorrow and start turning our state around. So thank you all so much. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.